I've been using DaVinci Resolve for every one of my video, and I've seen and used a lot of graphic packs that really sucks. Some of them are overpriced, and some of them are just suck. So in today's video, we're talking how do you properly export your motion graphic presets from scratch, and how to organize your macro structure so that you can change any adjustment in your edit page and start selling good motion graphic presets that are actually not suck. So let's open DaVinci Resolve. So first of all, I've already prepared some of the effects that I created recently, but I'm gonna share some tips that will make your effects more professional next time you create one. It is a simple like and subscribe call to action, where if you put it on top of one of your video, it will automatically fit your video inside the viewer. I also added this green marker right here, where you can put your anchor point at the mark, so that when you zoom in your video, it will perfectly fit your video to the timeline viewer. First tip is try to use a loader node for any placeholder or image icon so that when you export your macro, you can add that to your edit page. For example, like this mouse icon here, where I just connect the path of the PNG file. Another thing I did here is auto resizing so that whether your timelines is 4K or 8K or 1080p, it will auto resize the effects to fit that resolution. Basically, I just use a resize node and create an expression that references the main background node. So if you're wondering what is an expression in short is you can point the adjustment to depending on another adjustment. For example, if you have an ellipse mask, you can point the width to depend on the heights. Whenever your height is increased, the width will also increase. You can also point to another node as well, like if you want to point it to the background, you can point that adjustment to rely on some adjustment on the background. One thing to keep in mind is that if you want to do this auto resizing thing, you would need to be careful about the resolution of the image tab in each node. By default, as I remember, it is set to auto resolution, so you would want to turn that off for some of your node, for example like the text node, where the image tab will turn off auto resolution so that it's not gonna adjust depends on whatever resolution you select, or even some of the background like this hamburger bar here. It is a background color node, but the image tab also turn off the auto resolution, and our effects aspects will depend on our main background node. That's why our main background node leave the auto resolution on. I just realized it's a little bit confusing, so I'm gonna explain it more here. Reason why you need to turn the auto resolution for some of your elements off is because if you include a PNG image or logo inside of your composite, when you change your timeline to let's say 1080p to 4K, that PNG file will remain the same resolution, which is wrong. So you need to use a resize node at the end of everything to resize the whole thing up. But for some of your nodes, like the text node or the background node, that are placed before the resize node, which also contains that auto resolution, and that auto will resize that node first before the resize node occurs, which is wrong. So instead, you want to turn that auto off for the elements inside and leave it on for your main background so that when you resize the whole thing, the elements will also resize along with the background. Make sense? Let's get back to our video. Before creating your macro, think ahead a little bit. What adjustment do you want the user to be able to adjust on the edit page? Like for example, I want user to be able to adjust the text and the color of the button. So instead of you go ahead and create your macro, I would highly suggest you count your attributes first and think ahead how would you group your adjustment. Do you want to adjust it based on the type of the adjustment, like the text for the text, color for the color, or do you want to adjust it based on its elements, like button for the button, title for title, and image for image? So in this case, I want to group my adjustment by its elements. Each button or title has its own section in the inspector, such that all the nodes that relate to each section. For example, video title right here. I'll select the title node and all the related nodes. Then right click inside macro, create macro. We're not gonna create any macro yet, we just wanted to count the attributes inside. So in the macro editor, if you're not sure which one to choose, you can open the inspector of that node to see which adjustment is which, then choose accordingly. Let's say we want the style text, the fonts, the style, all the color, and the size, and tracking. For our transform node, where I want the center x and y, So in total, we will have 10 attributes. Then you write that down. These attributes will be very helpful when you create a label control later on. And you close it and don't save it yet. Let's do another one. The subscribe button right here. I want user to be able to adjust the text and the background color. So I'll select every node that related to subscribe button and I'll hit create macro again. Basically for the subscribe text, I want user to add their own text to change the fonts, to style the fonts and to change the color of the text. Then resize the text and also tracking. Then for the background color of the button, I'll just choose everything in the color section. Then for resizing the button, I'll just choose the center width and height and corner radius. And since we have two subscribe buttons, the one before we click the subscribe button and the one that after we click that subscribe button. So in total, we would need to multiply this by 2. So we would have 84 attributes. So you write that down. And let's say once you're done telling me all of your attributes, we can create some label control. Basically, you right-click on any node and select Edit Controls. Then you rename it to be whatever label name you want. For example, Video Title. Then you go under Input Control and select Label Control. Then you check this Show arrow. Then you type in the attributes that you count for your video title, which is 10. Then you hit OK. Then you will see that it's create a new tab inside the node that you add your label control. And it's stored in one of your label. Then you repeat that for each every element that you just count. You can now create your macro by select all of the nodes except the media out node. And you right click macro and create macro. Then you rename it to be something meaningful. Then choose all the attributes that we just counted. Once you're done selecting all of your attributes, then go into the file and save as. I'll choose my desktop first, then hit save. Then you can close the macro editor. Then you right click on the effects templates. Then you hit show folder. Then you go into the edit folder and into the titles. Then copy the setting file that you just saved and paste it inside the folder so that we can revert back whenever there's an error when structuring later. Then after you reopen your DaVinci Resolve, head into the edit page and find your effects that you created inside effects title and drag it into your timeline. Then you see that all of the attributes are shown in the inspector, but it's all over the place. It doesn't have any label assigned yet. So we need to assign the label that we created inside our label control node. So we head back to our Fusion page and we right click on the templates and show in folder again. Then you head into your file folder and open the .setting file. You can use a notepad or any text editor to open your settings file. I have this VS Code here, so I'll just use it. There's a bunch going on in the file. It would be a little bit intimidating for those who don't have any coding background, so I'll try to explain it as short as I can. First thing, you don't have to understand all of the code here. The main part that we need to deal with is all of the inputs right here, because it's the part that determines how your attributes are ordered in the inspector. So you can see that the logo right here is your logo right here. The style text right here is the input text. Then the font is the font. Style is the style. And the color is all the color right here. And imagine this as a box where each inputs were stored in a box called these inputs right here. So we have our title that's stored in a box called input 2. We have our fonts adjustment stored in a box called input 3 and so on. So when you move your box, the attributes in the inspector will also move. And as I mentioned before that I want to group them up based on their elements, right? So I would need to move all the boxes that related to the same elements. For example, video title, which contains the text, the fonts, the color, and so on, and group them up with our label control. So we would need to find all of our title attributes. And when you're working with thousands of lines of code, Control F to search for the word is your best friend. Once you move all the boxes related to your video title, we now can group them up with our label name. So we need to search for the label name that we created in our label control node. So in this case, it's video title. and remember the box name, which is video title with uppercase V and uppercase T, and head back to our inputs at the top. Then we will copy one of the boxes below and paste it at the top for our label box. Then we will rename our box name to be our label box name, which is video title. Then we will change the source operation to the node that we stored our label, which is label control. Then for our source, we will change it to our box name, which is video title. Then you hit save. Then you head back to the DaVinci Resolve and drag our effects again. Then all the adjustment related to our video title will be stored in the video title label. And if you count your attributes right in the first place, it should group correctly in your inspector. But if you're not, you can still change that inside our label box below, which is the num inputs. Then you repeat all the steps for each individual group you have. If you want to make all the groups show the adjustment inside by default, you need to search for the node name that stored your label and find the box name. Then you type in every label box that you have and change the value of the input to 1. And then whenever you drag your effects to your timeline, it will automatically open all of the adjustment. You can also rename the control that appears in the inspector by adding a name to it. And remember to include the double quotes to let it know that it's a text. You can also assign and move them to different page by adding a page to a box that you want to move and giving a name for that page. Then every box below this box will be moved to another page. So if you want just a single group to be moved, you will either need to move that group to the bottom or assign another page for the group below. And since we have a loader node, we would need to change the default file path. We need to store all of our icons used in one single folder. Then we will need to search for the word file name inside our setting file. And for each file name, you change the path to setting and colon, and followed by your folder name and file name that you store your icon in. Then you would need to place the folder that store all the icons in the same location as the .setting file. Now you can start creating a thumbnail that shows in the effects tab. You just need to create a PNG file. The recommended dimension is 104x58, but you can also use 1920x1080. Then you place that image in the same folder as the setting file with the exact name. Normally at this phase, I would move all the assets out and start creating a DRFX file. A DRFX file is simply just a zip file that tells Resolve which location to add the setting file to. And to make one, you would need to create a folder path that stores our setting files. So in this case, I would create an edit folder with capitalized E, and inside that create another titles folder with capitalized T and with an S so that our effects will appear in the effects title tab on our edit page. Then I'll create another folder with the effects name to separate it from other titles that I have. Once all is set, I'll move all the assets that we have into that folder and compress it into a zip file. Then rename it to a DRFX file. Then include whatever is needed for your effects, like a README file. Like if you use a special font, mention them in your README file or include them along with your effects and compress it once again to a zip file. Then I'll test install it once again to make sure there are no bugs or anything like that. Now you can start selling your own motion graphic preset on any marketplace like Envato Market or Motion Array. That's the way you properly export and organize your FX preset. A lot of work to do, right? That is why you need a graphic pack instead. And this is just a simple composite. Imagine if you need to do like 1,000 macro export. It would be all over the place. So hope you enjoy this. Hit the like button if you like this video and subscribe if you haven't already. If you have any question, comment down below. If I know, I'll answer it. If I don't know, I'm still gonna answer it. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Happy grading. Bye.